This is Miss van der Merwe, traveling from Tsumeb to J-Town, aka Grootfontein, with Fluffy her dog in the backseat, enjoying the wind through the side window. He barks as they pass by kudus alongside the road. So in this video, we are going to be looking at distance and how to calculate distance. So welcome to Rise Up Namibia. My name is Matty Anata, aka the resistor of bad and the lover of good, hashtag dark and lovely underscore, walk by faith and not by sight. So let's look at distance. What is distance? Distance is the measure of how much ground an object can or has covered between two given points. Okay, now how do we calculate distance? We use the same equation that we used in the previous video, which was speed equals to distance over time. Now how do we use this equation? Let's quickly just move it up there and then we bring out the symbol. Now this is the symbol equation. This is the same as this one. Okay, so the V represents speed, and then the little letter D represents distance, and then the T for time. Okay, so how do we use this formula to calculate distance? We simply use it by making D the subject of the formula. Okay, now if you don't know how to make like a letter or something the subject of the formula, I will be putting a link down below in the description that you can go follow and watch. Okay, so now there's a lot of ways how to make D the subject of the formula, but I personally prefer not working with fractions. So let's cancel out the fraction first, which is this D over T. Now how do we cancel that fraction out? By multiplying both sides by the denominator, which is T in this case. Okay, so we multiply this side by T and the other side, so automatically this will cancel out. Now what are we left with here? We are left with a D and then T multiplied by V. So we flip them and then that's our equation for distance. Okay, now some people are not familiar or don't really like making a certain letter subject of the formula, so they prefer using the triangle, which is also completely fine. So for people that use the triangle, decide if they are looking for speed, they cover speed, and they know that if they cover speed, it's distance divided by time. And if they are looking for distance, they know if they cover the D, it's speed multiplied by the time. And then if they are looking for the time, it means the equation will be distance divided by speed. Okay, now good, since we have our equation here for distance, let's give our scenario here some figures. Now before we give it some figures, let me just point out something, that once your speed is in kilometers per hour, your time should be in hours. Okay, if your speed is in meters per second, then your time should be in seconds. Okay, good. Now Ms. van der Merwe here, let's say she traveled 60 meters per second. She traveled at a speed of 60 meters per second. How far will she travel in 20 seconds if she was traveling at 60 miles per second? Now the first thing you need to check, always check your speed. What's the unit of the speed? It's meters per second. Okay, so now you check your time. Is your time in seconds, the time you are given here? Yes, the time you are given is in seconds, which means because this is meters per second and your time is in seconds, which means here it's correct, you just substitute it into your equation. So what's the time? It's 20 seconds multiplied by the speed, which is 60 meters per second. So sometimes it's good to write the units down because they help you. Because now you know you are looking for distance and you have like seconds here and seconds there, they'll like cancel out. and then you will be left with the m for meters. Okay, so what is 20 multiplied by 60? It will give you 1200 meters, and that's your final answer. Okay, now how about if you don't have 60 meters per second, but rather like the highway speed limit for Namibia, which is 120 kilometers per hour, and then your time is like 1800 seconds. Now again, check your speed here. You are given 120 kilometers per hour. Now, since your speed is in kilometers per hour, check your time. Is your time in hours? Now, when we check our time here, it's in seconds, okay? Which means you need to convert these seconds into hours, okay? Now, if you convert them into hours, and then you can as well just substitute them again into the formula. So you can't just start putting them into the formula. So you see what I did here. So the time changes to 0.5 hours, from 1800 seconds to 0.5 hours, multiplied by 120 kilometers per hour. Okay? So what will the answer be? Again, the hours will cancel out, and then you will just be left with kilometers. So what is 0.5 multiplied by 120? To give us 60 kilometers, which is the distance. Okay? And that's our final answer. So, thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, subscribe, turn on that notification button to be the first to see the next upload. Share with friends, family, and classmates. And remember, together we rise to higher heights, apart we all stay behind. Cheers!